National League divisions going up against the New York Mets. Joined by my partner Chris Singleton, I'm John Shumby. Plenty of storylines taking shape in this series as we set the stage for Game 4, Chris.
And I'll be interested to see if these teams approach it any differently, with one on the brink of elimination and the other just a win away from putting an end to this thing. You know, in the postseason, I think you have to treat every game the same, but there's something about an elimination game that could put a team just into a different mindset.
Yeah, and the strategy could certainly change in this type of game. It's hard to manage the same way when in any given at-bat, it can impact everything you've been working for throughout the season. First pitch coming your way next. So just about set. Today's starting pitcher, Luis Severino. What should we keep an eye on here?
Power pitcher. He's going to speed you up with the fastball velocity, and out of his hand will explode the breaking ball. Very difficult for hitters to keep that front side closed and hit the ball the other way, because they know if they're not ready to pull the trigger, the fastball will beat them.
Kyle Schwarber comes up to hit here. Ball to strike. The pitch. Swing and a tapper that rolls foul. And misses. It's a strikeout. Trey Turner at the plate. The 1-1 is fouled off. The pitch. Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single. Here's Bryce Harper. Severino throws to first, and he's back in standing.
Base runner with a one-way lead right there. All he's trying to do is get a look at the pitcher's move. Had no intent of stealing on that pitch.
And that one almost hit him. Right through there for a strike.
Good pitch to hit on a tee up in the zone. I think he was looking for something else right there.
Stays alive. Severino runs it up to 96 to record the punch out.
Great location with that two-strike fastball. I'll tell you what, as a hitter, you're looking to protect the outside part of the plate, stay back on something off speed. So many times, that location with two strikes, you just can't get around on it, and that's a tough one to compete with.
Here's Nicholas Castellanos. Left field, McNeil drifts towards it, and that is that. One left for Philadelphia. Now the Mets offense will go to work for the first time. No score. This is the National League Division Series on the show. Back here at Citi Field. And today's starter, Christopher Sanchez.
Try to stay back for that power changeup. Speed differential between the fastball and the changeup is huge. Hitters, they have a hard time staying back.
And stepping in for New York, Francisco Lindor. And he deals. Ripped to third and caught. Let's take a peek at the Mets lineup here. The challenge for him today, Singy, elevating the baseball against this sinker baller that's on the mound.
Yeah, that's the challenge, but it also might affect the way they approach base running in this one, Boog. You get a runner on first, you anticipate trajectory down, and when the ball's in the dirt with a good secondary lead, you break for second. So whether it's a stolen base or not, you stay out of the double play, get that runner in the scoring position, and that can help you put more runs on the board.
B.I.D., ball in dirt. And a pitch. Swing and a miss as he was late that time.
Ball count.
One down, base is empty. On the ground, right side. Jumps, throws, and very nicely done for the out. Two outs, base is empty. And now it's Mark Vientos. And now 2-2.
2-2 is the count.
Two outs. And down on strikes he goes. And it's a 1-2-3 inning. Mets go down quickly, scoreless after one. And welcome back to the ballpark. And now, Alec Bohm. Obviously a guy who makes good contact, hits for average, but one of the things in today's game, the value in the fact that he hits both righties and lefties. Here comes a pitch.
2-2.
They're so reliant on the matchups nowadays, Chris, and it's huge when you don't have to sit a guy or platoon him.
When you can hit, you know, both sides in terms of pitchers' arms, you're a guy that it's hard to take out of the lineup, and I think it's very important today when everything is under the microscope.
And you would imagine Severino in that power fastball, you're going to get it there in that count, and Severino just tricked him.
This is Bryson Stott. Swing and a little roller right side.
Ball.
And he grabs it in foul ground. One down, base is empty. Swing and a miss. Couldn't hit the fastball at the knees.
He's really good hitting the baseball the other way. So credit the pitcher for having him out in front of that pitch. Clearly he had him fooled.
Two outs, base is empty. And now it is JT Realmuto.
Ball.
That one a little bit high.
2-1.
2-1. Two out, space is empty. And a big swing and a miss.
Well, as a hitter, you're hoping that the command on that sinker doesn't come until later in the ball game. But if that's how it's going to be all day, it's going to be a tough one for the offense.
Ground ball, left side. Toss to Alonzo. And the Phillies are set down in order. Down quickly go the Phillies. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Bottom half of inning number 2. And now the first baseman, Pete Alonso.
Well, Boog, it didn't take very long for Alonso to set the home run record here at Citi Field. He passed Lucas Duda for the top spot in June of 2023.
The 1-1. And a foul ball. Good eye in that spot.
It's a good take.
Time to check on our umpires. Earl Hendricks calling balls and strikes.
Yeah, well-liked umpire, Boog. Pretty consistent with his zone, so if you're familiar with him and how he works, you won't get too surprised by anything. Sometimes he'll give a little bit off the corner, but nothing too crazy at all.
Way outside, and the count's full. And the pitch. On the ground to the left. Sends it across to first. And that takes care of Alonso. And now here's Jeff McNeil. Nothing, nothing here in the bottom of the second. This one in the air. Under it. They got it for out number two. And now JD Martinez. Two down, nobody on. That one finds the zone. Now one and two. Two outs.
Ball.
Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. Three up, three down, inning over. Nothing doing for the Mets. We'll move to the third with no score. Back here in Queens, Brandon Marsh steps to the plate. And the right-hander deals. Popped in the air. Left field, and there's one down. So up next, Johan Rojas. Singy, you gotta appreciate a guy who's this good defensively. I mean, watching him track balls in the outfield, it is beautiful. And a 1-1.
Nope, ball.
So how much does his speed factor into his ability to go get it?
It's heartbreaking for the hitter because off the bat, he thinks this ball is going to get down. Because of that speed and the ability to make up so much ground, he enters the picture and breaks a guy's heart.
One out, base is empty.
There's one guy that I can think about, Boog, who started as a third baseman, Alex Gordon, and then became an elite perennial gold glover out in left field for the Kansas City Royals. But he's a guy, when you watch him play, you would imagine that that's all he ever played in his life was the outfield.
Up the middle, Lindor. Throw off line, he's safe. And a nice job there to keep it from getting away.
Well, I definitely think the speed down the line played a factor on that throw. He had more time than he thought, but as a fielder, the speed of the game and the speed of the runner sometimes can get in your head, and he just rushed it and failed to make a clean throw.
So the Philly batting order turns over, and here's the Phillies' leadoff man, Kyle Schwarber. Severino checks over to first, and he's back. Yeah, some guys just have instincts, right? I mean, that's the way it goes. We talk about Larry Walker, the Hall of Famer, and his instinct on the bases, despite the fact that he didn't play a ton of baseball as a kid. And another ball. Remember Mark Kotze? He was a real good defensive outfielder. Good instincts, not great speed. Rojas, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming.
Yeah, and I figured you would get Kotze into this because you had a free dinner at his house the other night.
That is true. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
I'm not sure that was the exact location the pitcher wanted, but it worked. He got the swing and miss, and I'm sure a bit of sigh of relief after seeing that one go through the zone.
Trey Turner now. That one ripped. McNeil makes the play, and it's out number three. Phillies strand one, still no score. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And stepping in for New York, Starling Marte. The 1-2. That's down and in.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Couldn't catch up to the heater.
Really love the pitch sequence right there. I'm telling you what, pitcher and catcher on the same page right now.
Here's the veteran second baseman. One down, base is empty. Outside low, and it's 2-1.
Two balls, one strike.
Fought off foul. Swings, throw it in, that's a strikeout. Back-to-back strikeouts to start the frame, and that's now 3 in a row.
Yeah, he's really settling in and getting a feel for his pitches, throwing them where he wants to right now. So we'll see how long he can keep this streak going.
So up next for New York, Francisco Alvarez. Two down, nobody on. Swing and a miss. 3-2 now.
Count is full.
Still tied at 0. Last of the third. And that's ball 4.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is, if you are the offensive side of it.
Just off the outside edge, 3-1. Brandon Nimmo waiting to hit for the Mets. Two outs. Fouls one away, and now 3-2.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score it.
Up the middle. Sends it to first. Lindor retire. That's the third out. Inning over. Mets leave one, and we are still scoreless. And we're back. John Ciambi with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, Bryce Harper. The wind of the pitch. Line drive, base hit right field. So a man on base to start the inning. Nick Castellanos at the plate now. Severino throws to first. All tied up here in game 4. Swing and a ball popped up. He's under it. Puts it away for the out. And now it's Alec Bohm.
Definitely wants to stay out of the double play here. Ball on the ground in the infield. Should be an inning-ending double play.
A little off front there as he swings through it.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
And another ball. Harper leads off first with one away. Next offering is down low. Got him. Two down. So digging in now for Philadelphia, Bryson Stott. Swing and a miss, struck him out. Chase the fastball up the ladder for strike three. They get a leadoff single but leave him stranded. To the bottom of inning number four now. No score. Game four of the division series. Here's Brandon Nimmo. The 1-1. Right through there for a strike.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
Fights that one away, still 1-2. Swings and misses, struck him out. Next to hit, Mark Vientos. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two.
1-2, the count.
Right side. Stott over to first in time. Already two gone here in the home fourth.
That's what a good sinker is designed to do. Get a guy to roll over a little bit, hit the ball on the ground, kill some worms while you're at it.
Here's Pete Alonso. Two down, nobody on. Swing, and this one's bounced to the ground. Harper throws to first in time, and that takes care of Alonso. And the Mets go 1-2-3. Mets go down quickly, and we're still knotted at zero. And welcome back to the ballpark. JT Realmuto steps in. Severino kicks deals. Swings through that one out in front that time.
Well, that's that slurve right there. He threw it extremely well. Talk about just a ton of breaks. So tough to get that barrel to.
And that's outside.
2-2.
And a pop-up on the left side of the infield. Under it. And there's one down. So digging in, Brandon Marsh. One down, base is empty. Bounce to the left side, and that's just foul. And a 1-2. And that one upstairs. Next offering way upstairs. The pitch. Got him looking, and he didn't like the call.
Clearly looking out over the plate on that outer third, and that pitch finished right down the middle, just a little bit in, and he couldn't pull the trigger.
And digging in for Philadelphia, Johan Rojas. Falling behind 2-1.
Two balls, one strike.
And a foul ball.
Well, you put good velocity in the head of the hitter. He's got to get it ready early and then change speeds. Keep him off balance. That's the goal.
Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. Two down, nobody on. Here in game four of the NLDS. Misses inside, and it's 3-2.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Strike three, throws him with the front door slider. Phillies go down quietly in the inning. Halfway through this one, still no score. Back here at Citi Field, we head to the bottom of the fifth. Here's the left fielder, Jeff McNeil. Bounce to the right. Stop. Tosses to first. And the leadoff man set down in their half of the fifth. Now J.D. Martinez at the plate. The Mets still looking for their first hit in this one. Swing and a miss. And that's strike two.
The hitter early and off balance on that swing. If I'm the pitcher, I'm taking a little bit more off. See if you can get him to chase something in the dirt.
The wind of the pitch. Foul ball still, 1-2 count. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And now two gone.
Well, that's always the key to effective pitching is getting ahead in the count. And as a pitcher, it really allows you to start expanding the zone. Hitters become defensive, and all of a sudden that plate starts to get really wide. And what happens is, because of the pressure, you end up committing to a pitch as a batter before you recognize what it is, and that's what leads to the strikeout.
So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Two outs. Foul tip into the mitt, struck him out. And the Mets go down 1-2-3. Sixth inning coming up, still nothing on the scoreboard. Top of the sixth inning. So here's the Phillies DH, Kyle Schwarber. And this one could be extra bases. Makes the turn and heads for second. In safely with a leadoff double. Go-ahead runs in scoring position.
He was all over that one. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay. A chance now to take the lead, and at this point in the game, that could be a deciding run.
Go-ahead run on base. Here's Trey Turner. Swings through that one for strike two.
Well, here's a good opportunity in this inning to get on the scoreboard after that leadoff hit, and Harvey Order coming up right behind him. This is where they need to get going.
Phillies fans want a strikeout. Hit on the ground to the right side. Slides, but he can't come up with it. There comes the throw. It's offline, and he scores, and it's 1-0.
Raleigh gets it done in a big spot to get the run across. Just a simple ground ball the other way. They've had eyes on it, man. Sometimes that's all you need to do. Just let the ball travel, put the ball in play, and just hope it finds a hole. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
No outs, runner at first. And now here is Harper, and a base hit. Throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
Stringing them together. That's three hits in a row. Solid swing from start to end. On time with everything. Really good balance. Nice extension. And he met it out front for the line drive knock.
Nick Castellanos stands in for the Phillies. Kicks and deals. Just missed.
Well, he's just given up three straight hits, and now behind in this count to this hitter. Might be a good time for somebody to call a timeout. Maybe the pitching coach go out there and talk to him just a little bit.
And a swing and a miss. Stirring in the bullpen for the Mets. Oscar Brazoban, the hard-throwing righty, is up and loosening. Garrett warming up as well. Severino with another strikeout.
Came inside with that two-strike fastball nicely and just bunched him up on the inside part of the plate. Couldn't get around on it and catch it out front. Many times if you do, it's a foul ball. And you know, a lot of pitchers, they really don't like working inside with two strikes because they do not want to hit that batter. And when they've got him up against the ropes, got to figure out a way to put him away. Did a nice job right there.
And here comes the Mets manager to the mound. Pitching change coming. Luis Severino gives way, and a nice effort out of him, no doubt. New arm coming on. We'll be back for that in a moment. Tylor Megill on to pitch here. He has a great slider with tons of movement. And now for the Phillies, Alec Bohm. Two on, one out. Lined, and that's a base hit. Headed for the plate. He'll score easily, and they lead by two.
Well, there you go. The RBI machine. Another clutch run scoring at bat.
Yeah, he's been so good in these situations. Call it clutch if you want, but his resume speaks for itself. First and second, one out. Bryson Stott digs in now. Lindor flips it. There's one. Over to first, safe.
Well, that's great hustle out of the box to get down the line, knowing that a double play will end the inning. Good job at the finish, reaching out for the bag. Now they got runners on the corners and still an opportunity to pick up some runs.
And up to the plate is JT Realmuto. Two on, two outs. Swing and a ground ball out to short. Fires across the diamond, and Realmuto is out. That ends the inning and stops things from getting out of hand. So it's two runs on four hits, no errors, and a couple left on. 8-9-1 scheduled in the bottom of the sixth. It's the Phillies two and the Mets nothing. Back here in Queens, there we go, bottom six. Now it's the second baseman, number 11. The 1-1. And that one ripped to left, and it goes just foul.
Well, after scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
That's outside. And the count's even at two. Just off the outside part of the plate.
Expect for that guy to come right at you with a fastball, something in the zone, because he does not want to allow the leadoff walk.
In danger of losing the no-hitter here. Line to left. Marsh makes the catch, and there's one gone. Here's the catcher, Francisco Alvarez. The pitch. Called strike, a sinker at the bottom of the zone. The Phils holding on to a two-run lead here in the bottom of the sixth. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Caught him looking for the K.
Tremendous job of bringing that ball back over the plate. He gets just enough of it to get the call. And tell you what, as a hitter, it starts out of the zone. It looks really far away. And for it to catch the outside corner, you just have to tip your cap to the pitcher.
So the batting order turns over. And next for the Mets, Francisco Lindor. The shortstop takes the ball. The 2-1. Foul ball there. The lefty closing in on 100 pitches. He goes down looking. Down in order go the Mets. They trail things here 2-0. top of inning number 7. So digging in now for Philadelphia, Brandon Marsh. Here's a 1-1. Oh, that got away from him. And he's going to reach on a hit by pitch to lead off the inning.
Well, it's safe to say he won't be getting invited to the charity golf tournament this offseason.
Johan Rojas stands in for the Phillies. That's down and in. A slider missed. Comes up empty. That's strike two.
Sometimes being lucky is a swing and miss. If he makes contact with that pitch, probably hits into a double play.
Righty to the plate. And it's filled up.
So here we go. Base runner at first. Could be running on the pitch. He's got good enough speed to steal the bag to get in scoring position, even if it's a swing and miss at the plate.
Righty delivers. Gets a piece and stays alive. Swung on, belted. That one back there. Out of here. And they throw a pair on the board. It's 4-0.
Those are the at-bats that leave pitchers exhausted. He had to throw a lot of pitches and still gave up the long ball. That's a bad combo. Well, I'm not really sure how he kept that fair. When you're out in front on a breaking ball like that, such a good chance that it's going to hook foul. But not this time. He kept the hands moving forward just long enough to sneak it inside that foul pole.
Now here is Kyle Schwarber. Ripped on the ground a second. The throw to first. Schwarber out of the play. Trey Turner with a chance now. And that's outside. And a count 2-1.
Pretty easy to give up on that pitch right there. Started on the edge of the plate with the spin. You know it's going to finish well off the plate.
The 2-1. Yeah. Big swing and a miss.
He can live up in the zone all game if hitters will chase it. That's just too much velocity. Hitters got to look down in the zone.
Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. Swings through it for the K. Couldn't catch up to the heater. Two outs, base is empty. Bryce Harper stands in for the Phillies. Base is empty, two away, but two runs are in late here in game 4. Cut on and miss, struck him out. Out number 3. But two come across to score in the inning courtesy of this 2-run homer. It's now a 4-0 ball game. You're watching the National League Division Series on the show. Set for the last half of the 7th. Here's the center fielder, Brandon Nimmo. And now the lefty. Swing and a miss.
1-2.
Fouls it off, still 1-2. And a pitch. Good job to fight that one off. Just missed.
Ball.
That one just misses. 3-2.
He's really tightening up his hitting zone with 2 strikes here. I love it.
That's the third. Boom. Zips it across. He made the pitcher earn that out after a long at bat.
Well, we're clearly at that point in this ball game with the no-no going that we're anticipating seeing some history. Those infielders right now, they are on their toes expecting the ball to be hit to them.
The Mets hitless so far in the game. Misses inside. Ball two.
Talk about the right guy at the right spot. They really need a rally, and this guy is someone you can believe in to find a way to get on base.
That one misses, and the count is 3-1.
Here's an opportunity to do some damage and perhaps unlock this offense. 3-1 count. Be ready to turn on a fastball.
Here's a line drive, and that's going to end the no-hitter. It's a base hit. Around first, heading for two. Castellanos whips it back in, and they hold him at second. Maybe this is going to be the moment they start the comeback.
He made a great run at it, Boog. I mean, he had their hitters off balance for the entire game up until this point. And maybe he didn't get all the way to 27 outs, but he deserves a lot of credit.
Yeah, really fantastic effort. Gave us all a great show. And now we'll see what's left for him. Man at second with one away. And next will be the cleanup hitter, Pete Alonso. Vientos, the runner at second with one away. That one not close. 2-2. Stirring in the Phillies bullpen, Tanner Banks. The young lefty looks to be getting himself ready. Kirkering, the right-hander, also getting loose. Two down. Wouldn't chase that time. Worm burner into the outfield for a knock. Coming home. The throw in. Safe.
Well done. Narrows the deficit with the RBI there. Got the top of the ball a little bit, but not much. That was hit pretty hard through the infield, so I think he'll be happy with that swing. Definitely generated some good bat speed.
Here comes the skipper, and we're going to see a pitching change in this spot. Christopher Sanchez is done. Only two hits allowed for him, so a great effort. And we'll be back after a quick break to tell you about the new arm. Here's the new pitcher for the Phillies, Orion Kirkering. Man at first with one gone. Now the left fielder, Jeff McNeil. That misses the zone, and it's 2-1.
Well, with both starters out of this ball game, it now becomes a battle of the bullpens and just seeing which manager can match up better and who's able to get to the finish line.
Left-hand hitter waits, and that's off the inside edge. And now three balls and a strike. And a swing and a miss there. The Mets trailing by three near the bottom of the seventh. Swing and a high fly ball to left. Marsh moves under it. Makes the catch for the out. Two away. Here's J.D. Martinez. And here it comes.
That's the ball. 2-1.
That one fouled off. 2-2. In the air, right field. Castellanos makes the catch, and that is that. So one run in the inning on this base hit. It's now a 4-1 ball game. And welcome back to the ballpark. We go to the eighth, and now the right fielder, Nick Castellanos. That one catches the zone. Going to count 1-2. Out to short. Zips it to first. And that's one away as the leadoff man is out in the eighth. So up next, Alec Bohm. Base is empty, one away, and we're in the top of the eighth. One down, base is empty. And he hits a ground ball right side. A flip to the pitcher covering. Two up, two down here in the top of the eighth. Two outs, base is empty. And the batter now, Bryson Stott. The 1-1.
Throwing the ball well, and they need the scoreless inning in relief right here. They're doing a good job keeping him in striking distance.
Here's a 1-2. Cuts and misses. That's a strikeout. Phillies down in order as they hold on to a 4-1 lead. Righty reliever out of the pen, Carlos Estevez. Starling Marte up to hit. At the belt and fires. And that's off the inside edge. And a count 2-1. Swings through that.
It's been tough for the offense so far, but you can't get frustrated. You got to find a way to shake it off, go up there, and relax. That's the only way you're going to be able to put runs up on the board.
Close one. Doesn't get the call. And a full countdown.
He's mixing his pitches really well, late on that fastball after seeing the changeup. See if he can elevate one. I think if he does, he'll get the swing and miss.
Foul ball, and it remains a full count. Struck him out looking.
Well, he's going to have some thinking to do when he leaves the ballpark after this one. That was his third strikeout, and this one looking, obviously, so he's been a little overmatched. He's got to find a way just to be more competitive up there at the plate.
And the righty deals. And now 1-2.
It might be time to choke up a little bit, get that front foot down early, maybe even just spread out. He's really late right now.
Next pitch is outside. That to right. Castellanos on his horse. Makes the catch up against the wall in foul territory.
Man, Boog, I love watching an outfielder take on the wall to make that play. And it's a lot easier to watch from up here because that can be painful in the end. You know the wall's coming up on you quickly, so you have to maintain concentration and able to make that catch and hold onto it after contact.
No, that meant-
good eye right there.
Well, it's critical right here that they bear down and turn in some quality at bats, try to chip away at that lead, because if it gets to the ninth, that closer's coming in.
The 3-1 fastball for a strike.
You got a full count.
And that's too high, ball four. Out of the bullpen for the Phillies, Jeff Hoffman.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
Francisco Lindor comes up to the plate. Two outs. Swings through that one.
1-2.
The 1-2. Line drive, base hit. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out.
Showed a willingness to drive that pitch the opposite way. Didn't get jumpy, didn't try to pull the ball. He let it get deep, took the barrel right to it, and then extended through the swing for the line drive base hit.
Now a chance for Brandon Nimmo. Bounced out to short. Trey Turner gloves it. They get the force. Bang, bang play, and the inning is over. Two left for the Mets, and they trail it 4-1. We're back. It's the top of the ninth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Oscar Brazoban.
Pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches out of him right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
And digging in for Philadelphia, JT Realmuto. Kicks and fires in the dirt. 2-1. Brazoban, a very difficult guy to get hits off of. It's really rare for teams to string stuff together against him.
He wins every pitch, and for a hitter, sometimes a victory is.
Oh, now this one's high and deep, way back there, on its way, gone. A massive home run, and they add to their lead. It's 5-1.
Already playing with the lead, and now they're celebrating a home run. They're having a great time out there. Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spent on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
Here's the left fielder, Brandon Marsh. And it is 2-1.
Unless he beats himself, somehow can't find it, doesn't have the control command that day, you can pretty much forget about it.
Right-hander kicks, deals. And a swing and a miss. As a hitter, there's even more pressure to take advantage of any mistake, right?
Yeah, and you're hoping that, you know, somehow, some way, whether it's a hit by pitch, a walk, something bad happens, because outside of that, his stuff is just too good to fail.
Left-hand batter waits. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. And that's the first out. Nice recovery after giving up the homer. Johan Rojas stands in for the Phillies.
And he's got deception in his delivery, and it's not that he's trying to deceive the hitters. He just has this natural flow that makes it hard for hitters to pick the ball up. It gets on them a little bit quicker than they anticipate, even though they know what the velocity numbers are.
And a pitch. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. So that will bring up the top of the order with one away. Back to the top of the lineup. So here's the Phillies DH, Kyle Schwarber. There goes the runner. Pitch in for a strike. Safe at second with a stolen base. Singy, he definitely showed off the wheels there.
Yeah, and it turned out to be a bang-bang play. StatCast gives us the data, and that stolen base wasn't possible without that sprint speed.
Way inside, gets out of the way. Man at second. Got him swinging. Here's Turner now. Man on second, two down. That one the other way. He makes the grab, and that'll do it. JT Realmuto delivers yet again on this one. It's now 5-1. Last chance for the home team. And stepping in for New York, Mark Vientos. The 1-1. Swing and a miss as he was out front that time. That one way outside. Now 2-2. Pitch. Throws the high heat past him. That's a strikeout.
With that kind of velocity, an elevated fastball, even if it's still in the strike zone, can be tough for hitters to get on top of.
He's two outs away. And now it's the polar bear, Pete Alonso. The pitch.
Ball.
The Phillies leading by four. Here, the last half of inning number 9. Fouls one off, 2-2. And another ball. And that one hammered. That's back there. That's gone. That was blasted to the moon. And they close the gap. It's 5-2.
That swing just injected more drama into this one. Power. power versus power right there, like two locomotives colliding. Who's going to win? Well, a really good job there by the hitter getting the top hand working. Powers that fastball out of here.
Here's the new pitcher for the Phillies, Matt Strom. He's into the game with the bases empty. One out, bases empty. Jeff McNeil stands in. One down, bases empty. And that one clips the corner. And he deals. Struck him out looking. Now only one out remaining.
Well, just couldn't pull the trigger on the fastball right there, and I don't think he was taking it, thinking it might be a called ball or anything. I just think he was flat out frozen. Did not expect that location, in my opinion.
That one missing inside.
Two balls, one strike.
Next pitch misses outside, and that's ball three. That one down the line, and foul ball. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2.
Well, they gave up on that pitch early, and it ended up staying in the zone. I'm sure he's kicking himself and would like that pitch again.
And now the lefty gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit. Joey gets on base and keeps it going.
That's tremendous fight from him, and I know it's got the dugout fired up down there, down to the last strike, and he comes up with a hit to keep the game alive. It ain't over yet.
Here's Starling Marte. And now two balls and a strike. Good eye in that spot.
Pressure mountain right here with the tying run in the on deck circle. He's got to find the strike zone.
Three one is on the way. Sends it to center, and that's going to do it. Hauls it in, and that's the ball game.
This team played extremely well to force this series into a game five. It's just like a game seven. You win or go home. That game five should be a lot of fun to watch.
Your final score, 5-2. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi. Thanks for joining us.